Hi and welcome to my video. My name is Ezekiel and I'm glad you could join me. So on our previous video, we did some desktop app development. We did a basic introduction, got to know about the framework which was custom Tkinter. And one of the things that I didn't mention is that custom Tkinter is a cross-platform framework. What do I mean by cross-platform? What I mean is that custom Tkinter can be accessed by all three major operating systems. These are Windows, Linux, and macOS. Meaning that if you develop an app using custom Tkinter, the app can run on all these three major operating systems. With maybe a few minor changes. And on today's video, we'll be discussing about object-oriented programming versus procedural programming. Let's start with the procedural programming. Procedural programming basically means that you write function after function with no certain order. And the main difference between procedural programming and object-oriented programming is that in object-oriented programming, functions are added into classes, as we will see. So what are the advantages? Which should you choose? For me, and as it is advisable, we prefer using the object-oriented. Why do you think? This is because using the object-oriented programming, you are able to classify your work and put code into classes. This means that in case of any issue, it will actually be easy to pick up where you left and fix the errors compared to procedural programming, where you'll have to go over a bunch of lines of code. So let's dive into the code and let's see which is which. So we'll actually start with procedural programming. Open your code editor and create a file. Naming mine main.py. This is procedural. So this will be making an example of procedural programming. So to explain to you what procedural programming is, I'll be using a basic example of a calculator. So my calculator should add, minus, and maybe multiply. So I'll create three functions with those names: addish, add, minus, and multiply. So let me create my function. Add. So my function will take two attributes, A and B. Member factorization is something, is a key thing in programming. A single column could make your code not run, and it should return. A second function will be minus, and it also takes two values, A and B, and it should return A minus B.
them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that note like my aunt. Oh, then the last will be multiply. Trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. My mama gave us salt on them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that note like my aunt. She took us in. Shots fired off in that coast. It also takes two values. This is just an example. Yours can take more than two values. But I want to leave this as short as possible. Cause she ain't no dead, trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. My mama gave us salt on them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. Shots fired off in that coast of my in Python, trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won use heels. My mama gave us salt on them crackers called an artery. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she multiply. I think it's also common in other programming languages. So if I want to add, I'll come and call my function, then give it those two values. So the result, I'll create a variable called result, and I think I'll add. Crackers when we were kids, so clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. Shots fired off in that coast of my cousin, she ain't no dead. Trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. So let me give it the two values, maybe. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. Shots fired off in that coast of my cousin, she ain't no dead. So what does it return to do? My mama gave us salt and those who don't know, return brings back the value that you assigned it. I know in other programming languages it's used to terminate, but in Python, if I assign a function that has a return, it basically assigns the result to a variable. So if I print the variable result, as you see, it should give us the answer. So using a return and assigning the function to a variable will actually assign the actual value to the variable so that you can print it. Let me run mine. Salt on them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. Shots fired off in that coast of my cousin, she ain't no dead. Trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. My mama gave us there's something else that I'd also like to show you. So I know that in programming, if you're a beginner, you're used to using the addition sign to actually add a word to, let's say, a phrase. But there's an easier way. You first have to write the letter F, then add quotation marks, then add your text, then add the curly braces. I'm not sure that that's the right word for it. Curly braces. Then write your variable inside. So you don't have to use the addition sign. It's actually easy and a bit clean with only one line of code. Trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. My mama gave us salt on them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. Shots fired off in that coast of my cousin, she ain't no dead. Trying to empty the clip on the nest and I won heels. My mama gave us salt on them crackers when we were kids. So clutching on that knock like my aunt, she took us in. As you can see, you obviously know if you have the root sequence 9, but adding the F and this punctuation mark, writing this line of code, adds this sentence to the actual value. So, one key thing to note, number one, it's the return value. Giving a function the return value, let's say a digit, or maybe, let's say an integer, maybe a string or a float, any data type, and assigning the same function to a variable, you actually assign the end value to that variable, as we have seen. The second thing to note is this is way of actually adding a variable to your sentence. You don't have to use the addition. You have an easier, simpler way with only one line of code. It can also be used anywhere that you require a string. Just put the F, don't forget the quotation marks, and this calibrates which hold you variable. So we're basically seeing what procedural programming is. So in large projects, you'll end up having many functions, and in case one has an issue, finding it will actually be a big headache. So to ease in the work, we prefer doing object-oriented programming. So, let's put the word. So you first start by creating your class. I'll name my class Mal. It's advisable that your class, that the name of your class begins with a capital letter. Highly advisable, one of the best practices. And I'll also write my ad. I'll repeat the same functions. So the only difference is that those functions are put into classes, and you can give the, and the class name should be something relevant to what they're doing. So mine is math, because it does something to do with math: addition, subtraction, multiplication. So let me add my function. Similar to the first one, it takes two values, A and B. So for the punctuation marks, so it returns. A plus B. Add another function, minus. Those are text two values, A and B. So one thing to note is, if you actually want to be fluent in programming, the only solution is practice. So practice until you don't have to refine anymore. And finally, the last function, Okay, so we have already created our class, Mark, and given it functions. So there are three things you should note. So for you to call the function, you first of all need to initialize the class. So let's give it a variable. We give it the variable mal, small m. So this variable should be assigned to the class. So I'll assign it to my class, mal. And don't forget the brackets. So by class, this means that this function can only be accessed through the class. This is why it's object-oriented programming. So you basically have many objects, and from those objects, you identify the functions or methods. So for me to access this add or minus, I can only access it through this class. That's another key thing. So I've already initialized my class mal. The next thing will be calling the function. So to call the function, you need to write the same variable, then add dot. after I put the dot, you can see at least for me the various available functions, the add, minus, multiply. Let's do the add. I get two values, 4 and 10. But let's assign this to a variable. The variable will be resolved soon. So when it returns the value after the calculation, the value is assigned to my variable result. That's one thing you should note. It actually makes programming easy, efficient, and it's one of the best parts. So I'll come and print my result. Remember that an easier way to use variable and sentences isn't using the plus, but using the method that I've shown. So you first start by writing the F, then using the quotation marks. Then include the text you like, and the result is. So any space left in this line of code will be the same during the output. So remember the curly braces, then add your variable result.
So before we run this, there's something we need to note. As you have seen, maybe in previous codes, functions inside class have a value known as self. So what does this self mean? After creating a class and creating the functions, you need to notify the program that you're referring to the current instance of the class. What do I mean by the current instance? You can initialize a class more than 1 month. Before we run the program, there's something we need to note. If you've ever looked to sample codes, you note that if you're using a class, in each function they start with the value self. Let me correct that. So what does self mean? This value self tells the program that you're referring to the current instance of the class. Why do we do this? This is because you can initialize a class more than once. Let's say you have you're creating a calculator app, and your calculator app has many windows. Maybe on one side you have the buttons, on the next page maybe that's the currency, maybe on the next page the weights. So if you want to use this function multiple times, you need to initialize it in each file. So this word self tells the program that you're referring to the current instance of the class. So go ahead and add the word self to your function, to all functions, then run. So if you note, after adding the value self, when you come to running the program, when writing the function, you don't start with the word self. Yes, you leave it as blank. This self should not be added in your function. So, do you only have to use the word self? The answer is no. You don't have to use the value self. You can use any name you like, but most people prefer using the word self, provided it comes at the beginning of the values in a function. So let's run, see the output. As you can see, it said that the result is 14. We could change this value, but if you change the value has to be the same in all the functions. One thing you should note. So let me write down the instance. This is to prove that you don't necessarily need to use the word self. Let's As you can see, it still brought the same answer. So, what have we learned today? We learned about return and assigning it to a variable, meaning that functions with the return keyword, if they are assigned to a variable, the variable gets the value that the function returns. Meaning, if I were to assign any of these functions, the value of this variable will be this result. Second thing, we've learned about using variables and sentences together without using the addition. Say that the first thing you need to set the F, then the punctuation marks, then include your text, and use the curly braces to enclose your variable. That's something to note to ensure that your work is clean. And finally, learned about classes. So onwards, in all the videos that I'll be uploading, I'll mainly be using this object-oriented programming. It's used in the real world market, and it's better if you embrace it as early as now. So for the class, you can have multiple functions. You give the class a namespace relevant to what the class does. So I'll give my math because it does some addition. Next, you need to give each function in a class a word that tells the program that you're referring to the current instance. So you give ours instance, but you can also use the word self. For me, I'll be using self. And finally, when calling the function, you need to first initialize the class. I initialize mine, don't forget the brackets. And to access any function inside the class, you can only do that through the class itself. That's why I came here and wrote math dot then the function. And finally, when you use the word self in our class to indicate the current instance, when calling the function, you don't need to write it. I hope you got that correct. Go through the video until you understand. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Thank you. Goodbye.